Seen on a public stage. Not now, later. Our tale today concerns the firstborn son of Charlemagne and is entitled. But before we begin, let me assure you that what you are about to see is the true life story of Pippin. You see, there have been many misconceptions about Pippin. One, that he was
a hunchback.
That he was
enormously tall.
That he was
a midget.
That he was
completely bald by the age of 14.
But I beg you, pass all previous misconceptions aside and accept what we enact for you here today. The life of Pippin begins. Pippin as a child showed tremendous thirst for knowledge. Immersed in these pursuits, the years went by quickly. Charlemagne sent Pippin to the University of Padua.
And the faculty of the university granted him the title of Scholar of the House.
Pippin replied to this offer in his own deeply moving words. He may be a little nervous. This is his first time playing this part.
Could I have some more lights, please?
Well, he ain't that nervous.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge that you have given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books. I'm not exactly sure what it is I want to do or where I want to go. Everything has its season. Everything has its time. show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Gotta be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydream. Every man has his goal. People like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning. Nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've gotta be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner. To settle for something small, but I won't rest until I know I've got it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble.
A promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits.
Terrific.
You see, I know there is something.
Something fulfilling. Completely fulfilling.
Yes, that's it. Something completely fulfilling.
Oh, fantastic.
And I'm going to find it.
Journey, journey, a spot there. Exciting, mystic, and excited. Journey through our anodonic. Of Charles the Great.
The first day I was home from Padua, I tried to get an audience with my father, but they told me he was too busy. The second day, I tried to speak with him at dinner, but he was too drunk. Today, he came to visit me.
Enter Charlemagne.
This part is to be portrayed by an actor of enormous power.
A giant on the battlefield and in the bedroom.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome, baby.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Well, welcome home, son.
Father, I need to talk with you so badly.
Talk. Yes. Talking's good. Well, hello, son.
Hello.
You look thinner.
Yeah, I know.
So, son.
So,
last night, didn't you miss dinner?
Oh, No, Father, I was right there, but you had been drinking.
Of course you were. Yes, now I remember. I always remember. Well, how did things go in Padua?
Very well, sir. Some of my tutors said that I
good, was... Good, I'm a great believer in education.
And yet you've become the most powerful man in the world without it.
The most powerful man in the world? Oh, Pippin, you exaggerate. What about the Pope?
I rank you ahead of the Pope, sir.
Well, I happen to agree with you.
Enter Lewis. Pippin's half-brother, offspring of Charles and Pastrana. And after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical. Lewis loves weightlifting. Lewis loves wrestling. But most of all, Lewis loves Lewis.
Ha! 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 Oh, well done, brother.
Well done.
Yes.
Ha! That was magnificent. Did you know that this arm slew 20 Frisians just last year? And it's going to slay even more. Ha! Visigoths! Right, Father.
Why do I always get nauseous every time he calls me Father?
Enter Fastrada. Pippin's stepmother. Devious, crafty, cunning, untrustworthy, but a warm and loving mother. Dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Lewis.
Lewis! 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 Wow. Guess what Mommy has for you? Surprise!
Oh! 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 Mousy! Oh! Oh, you shouldn't have!
I'm glad you did, but oh, you shouldn't have! Help me put it on. Oh! Look at this! Oh. Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, it really is beautiful.
Isn't it, dear?
Yes.
Pippin! Pippin, do stand up straight. Didn't they teach you posture at Padua?
I failed posture.
Notice how straight Lewis stands.
Oh, yeah, he's a real straight stander, no question about that.
Look how I shine. Ha! Ha! Physicals! Ha!
Oh, we're so proud of Lewis, aren't we, dear?
Yeah.
By the way, darling, the royal treasurer informs me I've overdrawn my allowance account.
You're overdrawn again?
Oh, now don't be angry with me, my lord. You know how confused I get about money. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is worth the fornicating I'm getting. Well, son, now we can have a little talk. How have things been going with you?
Well, not very well, sir. I'm afraid I have some questions I have to ask you about the future of my life.
Welcome home, son, welcome home. I'm so glad to hear there's nothing wrong.
But, Father, there is something
welcome
wrong.
Welcome home, son, glad you're home. Will you be staying long?
Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about, Father. I wanted to ask you if maybe you could give
welcome
me some advice.
Welcome home, son, welcome home. Welcome home, son, glad you're home. We'll talk again soon.
The preparations for the Visigoth campaign were reaching a peak. Marksmen tested their bows and arrows.
Whoa, wow.
Swordsmen tested themselves against one another.
The swordsmen!
The panoply of war was being assembled. The sights and sounds of glory were in the air.
Glory! Glory! Glory's in the air! glory's in the air. What am I doing? I'm running around a dark stage like an idiot.
Your sword, sir.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me. I thought you were a warrior.
Oh, no. I'll keep it.
But you're not one of us.
I'm Prince Pippin.
Who?
Prince Pippin. One day I will be king.
And one day I'll be queen.
Ha! Visigoths! I think I'm going to go talk to my father.
The royal court of Charles the Great, Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire.
And a giant in the bedroom?
And a giant in the bedroom. Is now prepared to hear petitions.
Oh, great leader, blessed by God, sent to us from heaven to protect us from the infidel.
Oh, what is it?
I beseech you to reduce my levy of foot soldiers, cattle, and wheat. Due to a famine.
Denied! Next.
But, sire, that is unjust and tyrannical. Whoops.
Take that man away and hang him.
No. Charlie, you are a tyrant.
Next. Oh, not all that bullshit again. Out. Everybody out. Council is dismissed.
Wait, Father, wait.
Yes.
Yes, I know what I want to do now.
Well, good.
I want to be a soldier.
What?
I want to join you in your campaign against the Visigoths.
Denied.
But that's not fair.
Well, to an emperor, fairness is irrelevant.
You're taking Louis.
Of course I'm taking Louis. Louis is an excellent soldier. He's strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
No, but Father, wait. Please talk to me.
I'm busy.
You're always either too busy or too drunk.
Or suffering the insults of ungrateful offspring.
I'm sorry, sir.
Well, what is it I'm listening?
Well, Father, I'm your oldest son. That means I might be king one day. Fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. I mean, after all, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to bringing Christianity to the entire world, even if we have to kill every non-believer to do it.
Well, that's what I'm talking about. You're dedicated to something, and I just want to be dedicated to something too, with all my heart and soul. And whatever it is, I want to do it as well as I possibly can.
You know, that's a nice thought.
Oh, well, thank you.
You're welcome.
So, you want your life to have meaning, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, that's very ambitious of you, Pippin.
Oh, Father, stop all this bullshit and take me with you.
Well, that's more like it. Go get yourself a good helmet and come along.
Oh, I'm a soldier.
Right.
Me, a warrior. Finally a chance to be part of something important. A chance to use my sword, my arm, and maybe even my blood. Blood!
Glory!
I want you all to look at this map, study it, remember it.
But Father, why can't we just go out there and slaughter them?
You spoke, Pippin.
Since we're braver and stronger and have God on our side, why can't we just go out there and kill at will?
War is a science, Pippin.
Well, that takes half the fun out of it right there.
Now, there's plenty of fun when you win. Now go sit down.
Well.
Hello. It's a lovely. War is a science with rules to be applied. Which good soldiers appreciate a recall and recapitulate before they go to decimate the other side. Well, gentlemen, this is the plan for tomorrow's skirmish. The army of the enemy is stationed on a hill, so we've got to get them down there, and this is how we will. Our men in the ravine, that's the Aryan green, will move across the valley where they plainly can be seen, and the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue, for that's what we depend upon an enemy to do. Get them! And to guarantee their folly, we'll bring Bowman into play, who will fire just one volley and retire to Point A. And gentlemen,
and then the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilation, we can hear a grateful nation cheer.
Pippin, sit down immediately.
I'm sorry, Father, I just got carried away.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes, of course. War is a science, a breeding ground for brains. For though I cannot write my name, the men whose pens have brought them fame write endless paragraphs explaining my campaign. And listen to the crowd say, now when the foe see our soldiers marching through the lee, they will mount a charge to greet us at a point I've labeled B. And the bowmen on the hill, in yellow on the map, will leave their post to join the rest and fall into the trap that will cut off reinforcements and retreats of any kind, bearing principles of Aethelade, Daphelade in mind. And if all the ploys we pick to really work to plan to pass occur, do you know how long it took me to learn that line? We won't just have a victory, we'll have ourselves a massacre. And gentlemen,
and then the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilation, we can hear a grateful nation.
Then I shall not caution you again. War is a very serious business.
I'm sorry, Father. It won't happen again.
Now, in conclusion, gentlemen, so listen to me closely. I'll endeavor to explain what separates a charlatan from a Charlemagne. A rogue infested by generals, illustrious and various, though pompous as a Pompey, or daring as imperious. A simple rule that every great man learns by heart: it's smarter to be lucky than it's lucky to be smart. And if the fates feel frivolous, and all our plans they smother, well, suppose this war does shrivel us, there'll always be another.
And then the men go...
Don't even think about it, drop it! Sit down! Not there, there! Oh, he's new. And gentlemen, and then, no, gentlemen, no, no.
And then the men go marching up into the fray.
Yes.
Thank you.
another thing. I always like to spend the night before the battle praying. I would like my two sons to join me. Oh God, we are about to fight in your name and the name of your son. Ask for victory in combat tomorrow. Give us the strength to butcher the infidel, that the righteous may flourish on the face of the earth. Amen. Pippin, Lewis, it's time.
You'll be proud of me, Father.
I will try not to disgrace you, sir.
Very well, then. Follow me.
Battles, barbarous and bloody.
Killed or wounded. War of the Roses, 22,000 killed or wounded. And that sentimental favorite, World War I, 8,528,821 killed, 37,463,904 wounded. And let's not forget the biggest hit, one that we hold in special regard, World War II.
Thank you.
the victory for me and God.
I killed at least 25 of them myself, Father.
Yes, you and Pippin both did very well indeed. Pippin, but now it's time to rape and sack. Oh, yes, we also have to sing. Singing is absolutely essential to victory. Fall two men. Eat. Drink. Drink. Give thanks to God who has given us this, our victory.
Cheers.
Well, I guess it's too late to wonder who that man was.
Well, it is a little late, but if you're interested, I'm just a simple man, a Visigoth, but a good man. Yes, a very good man.
You're also a very lucky man. You had the privilege of dying for your king.
Words fail me.
Well, you know, of course, dying in battle like this, that means you're gonna be going straight to Valhalla, or wherever it is you infidels go, won't you?
Oh, absolutely. The king has assured us personally. It's just all this waiting around that gets me edgy.
Yeah, I know. Well, I hope you get to Valhalla soon.
Hope you get to heaven.
Oh, I will. Hey! I thought there'd be more plumes. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've gotta be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner.
A sorrowful lad. He had everything he wanted, didn't want what he had. He had wealth and filth and fame and name and all of that noise, but he didn't have none of those simple joys. His life seemed purposeless and flat. Aren't you glad you don't feel like that? So he ran from the deeds he done, he ran from deeds he just begun. He ran from himself, that's mighty far to run. Onto the country where he played as a boy. He knew had to find him some simple joys. He wanted someplace warm and green. We all could use a change of scene. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, sweet summer evening, hot wine and bread, sharing your supper, sharing your bed. Simple joys have a simple voice that says, take a look ahead. Would you rather be a left-handed flea, a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea, than a man who never learned how to be free, not till he's cold and dead? Yeah! Sweet summer evening, so full of sound, gaining a lover, gaining a pound. Simple joys have a simple voice that says, take a look around. Wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea, a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea, a newt on the root of a banyan tree, than a man who never learned how to be free, not till he's underground? Enter Bertha. Pippin's grandmother, warm, strong.
Still attractive.
Still attractive. Charlemagne's mother, exiled from court due to a personality conflict with her daughter-in-law Fastrada, now living in the country where she enjoys those, hey, sweet summer evenings, sapphire sky, yeah, yeah, feasting her belly, feasting her eyes, hey, simple joys have a simple voice that says, life's a living prize. Wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea, a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea, a newt on the root of a banyan tree, a fig on a twig in Galilee, than a man who never learned how to be free? Not till the day, not till the day, not till the day, not till the day he died.
point.
Bertha.
Yes, what is it?
It's me, Pippin.
Oh, Pippin. Pippin! Oh, I can't believe it! Oh, it's so good to hold you! Oh, to hold you like I used to when you were a little boy. Remember, Pippin?
Well, of course I remember, Grandma. That's why I'm here.
But you look terrible. You need some fresh air, some sun, some good food, some frolicking, some hanky-panky.
Oh, I don't know what I need, Grandma.
Oh, I know what I need, Pippin.
You haven't changed a bit.
But you have. Now, something is the matter. What have you been doing with yourself?
Well, Grandma, I went to war.
Oh, Pippin. No wonder you look so terrible. Men and their wars. Sometimes I think men raise flags when they can't get anything else up.
Grandma, sometimes you say some shocking things.
I try my best. But tell me, what's wrong, Pippin?
Oh, I don't know. Grandma, I feel empty and vacant.
Empty and vacant? Pippin, I want you to listen to me. You're going to hear something very wise. Don't take life so seriously. Just take things as they come along. Don't do too much planning. And don't do too much thinking. Now, how is that for wisdom so far?
Well, frankly, Grandma, it sounds kind of dull.
Oh. Well, it'll sound better with music. Maestro! Oh, he is so cute! When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataracts and guitar, you could squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year. But when your best days are yester, the rest are twice as dear. What good is a field on a fine summer night if you sit all alone with the weeds? Or a succulent pear if with each juicy bite you spit out your teeth with the seeds? Or it's too late to stop trying. Fortune and fate you're secure of, for there's one thing to be sure of, mate, there's nothing to be sure of. Oh, it's time to start living, time to take a little from the world we're given, time to take time, for spring will turn to fall in just no time at all.
It's time that I'm worried about.
Now, Pippin, just sit down and don't say another word until I'm finished. I've got three more choruses to do. Now, you can all join me if you wish. Oh, what a good idea. And that goes for all of you out there, too. Oh, all right, but just the choruses. The verses are all mine. I never wondered if I was afraid when there was a challenge to take. I never thought about how much I weighed when there was still one piece of cake. Maybe it's meant the hours I've spent feeling broken and bent and unwell. But there's still no cure, so heaven sent as a chance to raise some hell. Everybody alone,
it's time to start living.
Just no time at all. Verse! and long. Then give me a month to get ready. Now I can waylay some aged away and persuade him to bay in some cranny. But it's hard to believe I'm being led astray by a man who calls me granny. Come on, boys, one more time. And this time, let's hear it from everybody. A one, two, three. I refuse to grow old. I can stay young till I die. For I've known the fears of 66 years and troubles and tears by the score. And the only thing I trade them for is 67 more. Take it up. Thank you very much. I would like to take this one all by myself. All right? Oh, thank you. And I would like to take it from center stage. Boys?
And stop worrying so much. Maybe that's the secret. Just to enjoy all the simple things in life. The fresh air. The cool, clean water. The fresh fruit off the...
Oh, yes. And women.
Sex presented pastorally.
Women. My days are brighter than morning air. Evergreen pine and autumn bloom. But all my days were twice as fair if I could share my days
with you. Excuse me.
So warmer than fire coals, incense and stars and smoke bamboo. But nights were warm beyond compare if I could share my nights with you, to dance in my dreams, to shine when I need the sun, with you to hold me when dreams are done, and all my when youth is through. But I would need no memories there if I could share my life with
Yahoo!
Something worthwhile that I can do with my life.
Hey, man, you just got started. There's plenty of things you can try.
Oh, yeah, like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Good morning. Peasants revolt. King slays thousands. The king warned that any further dissent would be
be treated in the same manner.
Oh, I can't believe that. My father would never slaughter people just for protesting.
Now, would a newspaper print anything that wasn't true?
But my father can't just tell people what to think.
Why not? He's the king.
I don't care. People have the right to speak out freely.
Well, there's no doubt about that.
Well, something's got to be done about it.
You're absolutely right.
We are surrounded by injustice and tyranny.
And prejudice. Don't forget about prejudice.
We are talking about the execution of innocent people here.
That's right.
I'm finally beginning to see what my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that they couldn't care less about.
That's right.
I think it's got to stop.
That's right.
It's time for a change.
It is time for a change.
We've got to dedicate ourselves to a better world for all people.
Testing, testing.
Peace and justice must be restored to this great land. The tyrant must be overthrown. Terror and bloodshed must be ended.
I'm a politician.
No. You're a revolutionary, and baby, you're beautiful.
We need a leader with the wisdom and the courage to sweep out the old order and create a better world. Down with Charles, up with me.
Yes.
Speaking against his very own father that way. I'd rather be drawn and quartered than to think I was in any way responsible for what happened next.
Revolution!
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 Pippin, our leader!
Not old Pippin!
Power to the people!
We promise to follow Pippin, our leader, forever!
Forever!
Now, gentlemen, first, let me say that I admire the dedication and the courage which has brought you here this evening.
Forever!
Oh, thank you. Second, let me be honest about some of the dangers which may lie ahead. If during this insurrection any one of us is caught, the king's vengeance will be swift and terrible. You will undoubtedly be tortured, broken on the wheel, cruelly maimed, even dismembered.
Forget that.
But I am sure that the prospects of these terrible agonies will not deter you from joining me in... They may appear frightened now, but once the deed is done, once action against the king is taken, they will flock to my side. Maybe.
Oh.
Mama? If Pippin kills father...
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
Mama. But if father discovers Pippin's plot and executes him...
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
Mama. No matter what happens, I'll move up.
Yes, darling. In fear of my beloved husband's life, I brought Pippin's activities to his attention. Pippin is disloyal to you, my lord.
Well, every son is disloyal to his father at one time or another, my lady.
But Louis loves you, my lord.
Louis is an asshole, my lady.
Rejection. I took upon my tiny shoulders the task of effecting a rapprochement between two men for whom I felt deeply. Lord knows we've seen enough trouble already. We've had our fill of gray skies. So put down the vinegar, take up the honey jar. You'll catch many more flies.
My lady?
Will you be praying at Arles next month?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, but my lord, you always feel so much better after your yearly prayer on the 15th.
Yes, I do, don't I?
I sought out Pippin. Your father loves you, Pippin.
Peace and justice for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Still, your name will be on his lips when he prays at Arles next month.
He prays at Arles next month?
Alone and unguarded.
Alone and unguarded. What date?
The 15th.
What time?
When the cock crows. Oh, Pippin, Pippin, I beg you to end this estrangement between you.
Oh, I will.
May I tell your father of this resolve?
No, no. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? How sweet. Oh, your intentions make me very happy.
You have been a great help to me, Fastrada.
What sweet words could a mother hear? I know the parables taught in the holy book. I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm really helping myself. Might be intending to harm my Charles. I therefore decided to warn him.
Well, I'm off to Arles.
Bye-bye, my lord. Oh, dear. In the hustle and bustle of my lord's departure, I completely forgot to warn him. What a busy day. Events move so swiftly, it's hard for a simple woman like me to keep up. But I know that one day soon, I'll be able to say the words that every mother wants to say. My son, the king. Mothers out there. Woo!
League plots to bring disaster. The chapel at Arles.
It's all right, Father. You may come in.
I'm sorry to disturb you, my son. I know you like to pray alone.
You know who I am, Father?
Well, of course, my son.
Well, you want something from me then, perhaps? A favor, advancement?
No.
Then what, Father?
I'm here to be with you for one moment. To touch you. To look into your eyes.
And what do you see?
The death of thousands. The slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see all that in my eyes.
Do you deny it?
Deny it? Why, I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos. If slavery, blood and death are part of that order, then so be it.
But those are words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son?
Yes, Father.
It is easy from where you stand to judge the things that I have done. When I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. I stood in the mud on the shores of the Volga. I drowned 2 legions in the Vistula. By eagles, ospreys, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things look clear. Birds float on the wind. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent and shaped an empire with it.
Oh, baby, that was beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, child, I love it.
So, do you think that you can do better than I?
Yes, I do.
Well, if you truly believe that, then there's only one thing for you to do.
Oh, thank you. I brought my own.
Why don't you use it?
Well, Father, there's got to be another way.
None. Now, if you have no further business with me, go and leave me to my prayers.
What do you pray for, Father?
Strength. And may God grant you the same.
When ancient ghosts are waking, so many plans need making, so many steps need taking, I think I will. I think I and sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due. Morning glow, fill the earth. Come and shine. I hope I can make a better world.
Oh, morning glow, I'd like to help you grow.
We should have started
I think it's a little big.
Oh, baby, a little tissue paper will fix that right up. King Pippin, Emperor of the Roman Empire, is prepared to hear petitions.
Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun has attacked in the east. Oh. He has destroyed 3 villages, raped hundreds of women, tortured and murdered thousands of your royal subjects. Oh. I await your orders.
Well, I hereby order you to seek out the enemy and negotiate a settlement.
As you wish, sire.
King Pippin the Peaceful.
Sire, the royal treasurer has refused me my allowance account.
9-2.
Oh, come on, you two. From now on, all royalty, including myself, must forego all luxury and extravagance.
Boy, what a crock.
King Pippin the Humble.
Sire, I met with the Hun. He will withdraw on one condition.
You see what I tell you? There's not one problem that can't be solved by just sitting down and talking about it. Now, what's the one condition?
He demands your reproductive organs separated from the rest of your anatomy.
What? Hmm? Oh. Well, in that case, I hereby declare a limited police action.
Oh, what the hell? You can't please everybody.
But, sire, I have no men to wage a campaign. I have no money to buy supplies. I have no army.
Oh, well, would you excuse me for a minute? Nobles! You remember that decree I made a little while ago about land and taxes?
Yes, sire, what about it?
Well, that's off.
You mean you want me to pay taxes again and raise an army?
Yes, that's right.
But, sire, without land, I have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Oh, well. Hey, that is a very good point.
That is a very good point!
I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? Now why the hell should I work when the poor are getting handouts from the royal treasury, huh?
I'll bet he says, you're absolutely right.
You're absolutely right. I hereby revoke charity to the poor.
Oh, fine, sire.
I'll take her away and hang her.
Woo, girl, you should have kept your mouth shut. Come on, baby.
Oh, no, wait. No, this is, no. Just let me think for a minute.
Oh, the king is thinking!
Please, let the king think!
The king is thinking!
Darling, you're doing a wonderful job.
But I haven't been able to change one single thing.
Well, that's exactly what I mean. Your father would be so proud. Now, about my royal allowance.
Denied!
King Pippin the Unpopular.
What are you praying for?
I'm praying for strength.
Is there anything else you'd like?
Well, yeah, I'd like to get my father back his job.
Is that what you want?
Well, yeah.
You want it? You got it.
I'm sorry, Father.
Well, that's all right, Pippin. Just don't let it happen again.
Damn it! Nothing turns out the way I thought it would. Look, I know this is a musical comedy, but I want my life to mean something.
It will. frazzle, peaked as any out, flushed and rushed and razzle-dazzled. Dry your lip, damp your scalp. Now I can see you're in a rut, in disarray. Now I'm not one to button, but that I must say, if you take it easy, trust a while, don't feel blue, don't look back, you'll pull through in just a while, 'cause you're each cul-de-sac, 'cause each step's indispensable when you're on the right track. Hey! Yeah, yeah! Take it easy. Dance on it. Take it easy. Dance on it. Take it easy. Yeah, hey, hey. Oh, yeah, hey. Pippin jumped back into life with his usual zest. He tried art, the creative life, and you know, he wasn't too bad. But what he discovered was,
you gotta be dead to find out if you were any good.
And then he dedicated himself to the church. Pippin sought out God in the highways. Ha! He sought out God in the byways. Ha! And then he cornered him in a huge cathedral. But what he found out was,
the church isn't saving souls. It's investing in real estate.
Many, when things get dank, will feel their grip. Baby, you're on the ride. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Track. Ha! Enter Catherine, a widow with. Enter Catherine. Where is she? Get the girl.
Thanks.
Oh. I'm sorry. I couldn't get my eyelash on. My zipper got stuck.
No, that's okay, baby. We'll just try it again, okay? Get on over there. Enter Catherine. A widow with a small boy and a large estate.
When I first saw Pippin, He was lying in the road like a discarded rag. I would have passed him by. Perhaps I should have passed him by. But there was something about his foot. Yes. It was the arch of his foot that caught my eye. What I did next was merely an act of Christian charity. Well, Pippin, I'm sure there are many things you'd like to know about me, aren't there?
No, nothing at all.
Good. I have a son. I own this estate. I'm your average. Every decade or so, I'm your everyday, customary, kind woman. Practical and soft, modest to a fault, conservative with a budget, liberal with money. Just your average IT. May not interest you much at all right now, but things change.
Blink.
Things change.
Blink.
Still, I'll understand if I'm not your kind of woman. Anyone can. Condition can resist the charms of a small boy. So,
enter Theo, a small lovable boy with a large lovable duck.
Pippin, Pippin, say hello to my duck.
How do you do?
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong. His name is Otto. You're not very smart.
Well, I'm smart enough to know a duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Oh! Obviously hopeless rejecting a small, lovable boy like that. I picked him up off the street. I could throw him back out again. Out he goes! I'll give him another chance. Pippin, you've been lying in this bed for 7 days. Now, what is the matter with you?
It's nothing you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance. Please, Pippin. Please.
All right. You see,
to be completely fulfilled, and it's never ever happened to me. So, I am in abject despair.
And that's it?
Yes, that's it.
Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then, one day, he was struck by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt my life too was over. Oh. Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here and I can't do the work all by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
Hold it, baby, hold it! Actresses, you are supposed to read the line naggingly.
But he touched my hand, they don't usually do that.
I don't care where he put his hand. Read the line naggingly.
Naggingly.
Lee.
Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here and I can't possibly do all this work all by myself. So could you please help me?
All right, all right. Anything to shut you up.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working. And slowly he became part of everything. Part of our everyday life.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day?
Oh.
Every day. That's exciting. Whoa. Did you say something?
No.
I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a small boy and a large estate and nobody to sit at the head of the table.
For a while, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm for the work. But as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
Keep up the good work, boys. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Okay.
Oh, Pippin, there is something. The roof on the chicken house has sprung a leak. If you could get to it tomorrow.
Now, wait a minute.
Or the day after tomorrow.
The roof on the chicken house? I used to be the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire. Well, all right, so I screwed it up. Patching the roof and pitching the hay is not my idea of a perfect day when you're extraordinary. You gotta do extraordinary things. Oh, it's hard to feel special. It's hard to feel big. Feeding the turtle and walking the pig. It's so secondary to someone who is very extraordinary like me. If the moat won't stop leaking, the goat won't stop shrieking, the griffin keeps losing its hair. If the west wing is rotting, our best wine is clotting. I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. I gotta be someone who lives all of his life in superlatives. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. The fact that I'm different is easy to see. So why doesn't anybody know it but me? I'm extraordinary. I gotta do extraordinary things. Every so often, a man has a day he truly can call his. Well, here I am to seize my day. If someone will just tell me where the hell it is, give me a chance, give me my wings, and don't make me think about everyday things. They're unnecessary to someone who is very extraordinary. Luminary, I am! Hey, that's it. I'm leaving. I'm getting out.
And then Theo's duck got sick.
Pippin! Pippin! Otto is sick.
Oh, that's too bad. Theo, I'm sorry.
Pippin, it's the first time he's come to you for help.
Could you look at him, please?
Please, Pippin.
Theo, I don't know anything about ducks.
Pippin, try.
Oh, come on, let me have a look at him.
Now say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck. There's nothing I can do for him. Oh, Theo, yes there is. Yes there is. Come here, kneel right down here next to me. Yeah.
It was like a painting. Man and boy at prayer.
God, I know this is going to sound ridiculous, but this boy loves this duck.
His breath has ebbed. His pulse is low. His feet are webbed. But even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we've kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck or run amok. To prayers we stuck. Please reward our applause.
Sunset, the duck died.
Oh, Theo, I'm sorry. Theo, we can go to the pond and get another duck. Oh, why did the damn duck have to die? Forgot. You know, I think...
Yes?
It'll be better.
Next time?
Next time.
I think we're gonna skip this part. Nothing much really happens.
A little bit of this,
a little bit of that, a whole lot of that. But seasons change, as they often do. Pages fall off the calendar and blow into the wind. And then it happened. Suddenly, shamelessly, and without warning, as it does in all musical comedies, they were struck by a lust.
Thank you.
the floor and talk until dawn.
Candles and confidences,
trading old beliefs and humming old songs,
lowering old defenses,
singing a love song. La 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 la. Private little jokes and silly pet names,
lavender soap and lotion,
all of the cliches and all of the games,
and all of the strange emotions,
singing a love song. La 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 la. Love song. La 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 la. Say the whole is greater than the sum of the parts it's made of. Well, if it's true of anything, it's true of love. Cause how can you define a look or a touch?
How can you weigh a feeling?
Taken by themselves, now they don't mean
together they send you really
into a love song. La 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 song. La 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 la.
Under the dam.
Over the dam. Water flows over the dam.
I'm sorry, I seem to be a little confused.
Oh, baby, I can see that. You just try sticking to the part.
I will.
Uh-huh.
I will. In the 6 months that you've been with us, a lot of water has flown over the dam. You've come to mean a great deal to me, to us. And now, well, now, Pippin, we have so many good years ahead of us, and, oh, Pippin, sit here. Sit right here at the head of the table. Isn't this wonderful? Well, isn't anybody going to eat my pudding?
I am.
Well, I gotta get out of here.
Pippin, what's the matter?
I just can't stay here.
Well, I don't understand.
I've got to go.
Why?
Because this isn't enough.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am sure. I'm not gonna be stuck doing the same damn thing every day.
And night.
Look, don't you see? There's got to be something more than this. There has to be.
Maybe there isn't any more.
I know there is.
Rivers belong where they can ramble.
I love my husband very much. And then one day he was struck by... I'm sorry, I can't seem to remember my lines. Something's going wrong here. It isn't supposed to be like this. Could you hold that light a minute? Please. Thank you. I guess I'll miss the man. Explain it if you can. His face was far from fine, but still I'll miss his name and wonder if he's missing love. Sometimes he wouldn't say a pleasant word all day. Some days he'd scowl and curse. But there were other days when he was really even worse. Some men are heroes, some men outshine. Wasn't one, and I won't miss his mood, his gloomy solitude, his blunt abrasive style. But please don't get me wrong. In a long, long while. And the arch of his foot really was in a class by itself.
From the beginning.
Oh yeah, what's that?
That your search for enlightenment and fulfillment was doomed from the start.
Nothing ever turns out the way you think it's going to.
It's all flawed one way or the other.
Isn't that true?
Nothing has been completely fulfilling, has it, Pippin? Has it?
No. I guess there is nothing.
Wait. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, there is something.
There is?
Oh, yes.
What?
The only completely perfect act in our repertoire. The finale!
Finale?
Huh?
But that's just a trick.
When he does it, it's just a trick. But when you do it, it'll be for real.
When I do it. You mean you want me to walk into that box and set myself on fire? Hey, wait a minute.
You will step into that flame, Pippin.
Become a part of that flame.
Be engulfed by the flame.
Become flame itself.
And for one moment, shine with unequaled brilliance.
And in that flame, become the glorious synthesis of life and death.
And life again.
The final affirmation of life, death. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the great Pippin in our grand finale, never before seen on the public stage.
Stop it. Look. If this finale is so spectacular, why don't one of you do it?
Cute. That's real cute. Look, we're just your everyday run-of-the-mill people. Just your ordinary men and women who keep this old world spinning. Hell, we're nothing. But you, Pippin. You are an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams.
You deserve an extraordinary climax.
An unparalleled finale. It's everything you've been looking for.
Your dream.
Perfection.
Like the sun blazing in the sky.
The sun at its zenith. About the sun. Think about her golden glamour, how she lights the world up. Well, now is your chance with the guardians of splendor inviting you to dance. Pippin, think about the sun. Oh, yeah.
This is what you've been looking for. Your chance to wake
me. No, I really can't do this. This is dangerous.
Now, Pippin. Now, it's time. You're not going to disappoint all these people at $40 a seat now, are you?
Well, look, it's just that if this isn't it, I'm gonna have a tough time trying something else.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Pippin!
You know, you lack a certain amount of poise.
Think of the radiance.
Remember the beauty.
Admiring glance.
Thundering applause. Think of the word of mouth.
Think about your life.
Days are tame and nights are
slow. Think about the beauty.
Yeah.
is to the sea. And if I'm never tied to anything, I'll never be free.
What the hell are you doing here? Pippin, wait, man, the finale, the finale! We promised these people a grand finale.
You coward!
Come from my sir.
I might have known you'd screw things up. You and that damn lovable kid of yours.
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a simple thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. It never was there. I think it was here.
All right. You'll see what it's like without us. Okay, people, let's get the sets out of here now. Move it. Move it now! Oh. Color lights. Take the color lights out, Ed. Take them out now! Things don't look too flattering now, do they, Pippin? All right, get these costumes up. Go, Miss Blue, go! Look at that. Go, get the makeup off. Go. Costumes, it's off. Ha, ha. Ha, ha. How do things look to you now, Pippin?
Showed me crimson, gold, and lavender, a shining parade.
A mole! Look at that mole on her face! You gonna spend the rest of your life with a woman with a mole!
But there's no color I can have on earth that won't finally fade. I think it was here.
No lights.
Cause it never was there.
And no magic! Apologize for our inability to bring you the grand finale that we promised. It seems our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations. But I know that there are many of you out there, extraordinary people, exceptional people, who would gladly trade your ordinary lives for the one chance. One perfect time, our grand finale. And you should decide to do so. We'll be here for you, waiting. Why, we're right inside your head. And we promise you sex, costumes, magic! Ha! Above all, a short but spectacular career! One of your best. Yes.
Come on, y'all. These people ain't doing nothing. Let's get out of here. Come on, let's get out the rest of the lights. Let's go. Orchestra, pack up your fiddles, baby. We gone. Horns. You try singing without music, sweetheart. Ha!
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a simple thing from life. I wanted so much.
Pippin, do you feel like you've compromised?
No.
Do you feel like a coward?
No.
How do you feel?
Trapped. But happy. Which isn't too bad for the end of a musical comedy. Ta-da!